All right, Shalom, another GMS on the go, back with another lesson. First and foremost, I want to give all praise, honor, and glory to the Heavenly Father and His only begotten Son, Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakakwadash. Next, double honors to the head apostles, / elder bishops of Great Millstone, the one that taught me the 100% truth according to the Bible. Peace, blessings, and safety to all you sincere Akims. Keep pushing, keep believing, keep the faith. Regardless of people here, forbear, just a quick little lesson on fear, which is the beginning of knowledge, wisdom, and understanding of the scriptures. So the first scripture we're going to go to, Psalms 34:9. Oh, fear the Lord, ye his saints. Who are the saints? The Israelites, so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. We are the saints, right? For there is no one to them that fear him. You're not going to be lacking anything in the time of Jacob's trouble, in the time of perilous times. The scriptures tell you the servants of the Lord are going to eat. But 2/3 and these heathens, they're going to starve. You see, my servants shall drink, but they shall be thirsty. And you got to ask yourself, are you fearing the Lord? Are you serving the Lord? Because if so, then you ain't going to lack anything when troubling times come. But the people on the earth, man, they're going to really go through it. The Lord is going to really put these people through it, man. Once again, Psalms 34:9. Oh, fear the Lord. Yahweh Bashim Yahushai. Plus, it tells you, if I jump up, Psalms 34:6-7, those that fear the Lord got angels kept around them to make sure everything is going well, right? For there is no one to them that fear him. We're just going to be going through them pretty quick, kind of pressed for time, trying to just hit something before I go to work. This is St. Luke chapter 12, verse 5. But I will forewarn you whom ye shall fear. Fear him. Which after have killed, have power to cast into hell, which is a condition played out on earth. Once again, the Lord can take your spirit out of that body, send it back up to the heavens, destroy that body, send that spirit right back down into another body that's paraplegic, that's subject to all kind of illnesses, you know what I'm saying, seizures, you know what I'm saying, you name a body, you know what I'm saying, they can't walk, they can't hear, they can't see, that's hell. That's what you can say is hell, a condition played out on earth, right? Yea, I say unto you, fear him. So that's the beginning of wisdom. Once again, it's to fear the Lord. Matter of fact, let's get it right quick. Let's go ahead and get it. We go through what we got to go through, but the Lord sustains us every day. Give thanks, praise, honor, and glory each and every day for the Heavenly Father, send his only begotten Son, that we may live again. Proverbs 1:7, the fear of the Lord, Yahweh Bashim Yahushai, is the beginning of knowledge. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. But fools despise wisdom and instruction. So blockheads, meatballs, all you Israelites that despise this word, that hate this word, you're going to be destroyed, man. You see, indignation, righteous anger is going to come upon you, man. Once again, Proverbs 1:7, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. And the majority of our people, they don't fear the Lord. They worship in the spiritual demon Satan and his physical counterpart right about now, Sleazy E. So only people we worried about, only people we pray for is the elect of the nation of Israel. We don't pray for 2/3. Destruction is coming their way. So I got a couple more scriptures and I'm going to wrap it up. Matter of fact, let's go to Job right quick. Let's go to Job. Go to Job, the 28th chapter. This is Job chapter 28, verse 28, and it reads, unto man, and unto man he said, behold, the fear of the Lord, Yahweh Bashim Yahushai, that is wisdom. And to depart from evil, wickedness, is understanding. But the majority of our people don't know that. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. That is wisdom. When you fear the Lord, that is wisdom. And to depart from evil is understanding. So the majority of our people, they have no understanding whatsoever. And look, and ain't judgment coming upon them? The Israelites, you know what I'm saying, they don't fear the God of the Bible. Ain't judgment coming upon them? Swift judgment is coming upon them. The Lord said, look, they don't fear me. Don't pray for them when all hell break loose. I want to get that right quick. Jeremiah chapter 11. Verse 14, therefore pray not thou for this people, for the Israelites, the 2/3 that don't fear the God of the Bible, don't pray for them. Neither lift up a cry of prayer for them, for, for I will not hear them in the time that they cry to me for their trouble. And that's exactly what's coming, Jacob's trouble. All hell breaking loose. And two-thirds going to go through a whole world of pain, man. All right? And it ain't no way out because the God of the Bible says, I kill. Matter of fact, let's get that. Let's get that right quick. It's going to get it. The Lord said, don't pray for them. When they catch a prayer hell, when they end up homeless, when they ain't got nothing to eat, when they stomach touching their back, nah. Deuteronomy 32. Remember, these are the same people they ignored the words of the Bible week in and week out. We bring out all kind of lessons, starting off with the head apostles and the elder bishops of Great Millstone and the men on down. Videos day in, day out, week in, week out. Just remember, they ignored it. They didn't think nothing was going to happen in their lifetime, so they lived a careless life. Let's get this, though. Deuteronomy 32, 39, see now that I, even I am he, and there is no God with me. I kill, this is the Heavenly Father speaking, I kill, and I make alive. I wound, and I heal. Neither is there any that can deliver out of my hand. That's why we must fear. No one can get you out of the clutches of the Heavenly Father or his only begotten Son, man. No one. Let's get to Sirach right quick. Sirach 2. Through the Spirit. Sirach chapter 2. Verse 10. Look at the generations of old and see. Did ever any trust, meaning have faith in the Lord? Yahweh Bashim Yahushai was confounded? Was put to shame? No. Or did any abide in his fear? There it go again. Did any abide in his fear and was forsaken? No. Or whom did he ever despise? Whom did he ever hate that called upon him? For the Lord is full of compassion and mercy, long-suffering, and very pitiful, and forgiving sins. That's why we must repent. Sin is transgression of the law, and saveth in the time of affliction. And that's what's coming, affliction. Our people are being afflicted right about now. But have they turned back to the Lord yet? No. They don't feel like it's time. Well, when is the right time? The scripture says it's high time to awake out of sleep. Make no, let's get it right quick. This is Sirach chapter 5. It talks about, it ain't the right time yet. It ain't the right time. Well, when is the right time to seek the Lord? You gonna wait for all hell to break loose? Sirach chapter 5, verse 7. Make no tarrying to turn to the Lord. The word tarry means to wait. Pretty much procrastinate. No, don't procrastinate when it comes to seeking the Lord. Vengeance is coming. Wrath is coming. Death is coming. All hell breaking loose is coming, man. Make no tarrying to turn to the Lord. And put not off from day to day. Don't say, I get to it later. No. Look. Later might be too late for you. For suddenly shall the wrath of the Lord come forth. For suddenly, when you least expect it, shall the wrath of the Lord come forth. And in thy security, when you think you safe, and in thy security, thou shalt be destroyed and perish in the day of vengeance. That's exactly what's coming, vengeance. The majority of our people are going to perish in the day of the Lord's vengeance because the day of the Lord is cruel. We'll get it right quick. I'll make this my last one. Matter of fact, I got one more after this. This is Isaiah. Remember, the day of the Lord is cruel now. Let's get it. Isaiah 13 and 9. Behold, the day of the Lord, Yahweh Bahashim Yahushai, who they even call God of Jesus Christ, cometh, cruel, both with wrath and fierce anger, to lay the land desolate, to destroy this land, Babylon, a.k.a. America, the land of confusion, and he shall destroy the sinners thereof out of it. That's why we must repent. Fear the Lord. Matter of fact, still in the book of Isaiah, Isaiah 55. Remember, the Lord kills, keeps alive, wounds, heals. Neither is there any that can deliver out of his hand. You Israelites going to see Isaiah 55 and 6. Seek ye the Lord, Yahweh Bashim Yahushai, while he may be found, while the men are still pushing his word, while we still out there on the highways and byways, Abaratazah, call ye upon him while he is near, and we got the names to call on, the Heavenly Father, the Most High Yahweh. He is, he exists, and his only begotten Son, Lord Yahushai, he saves, he delivers, who you eagerly call Jesus. Call ye upon him while he is near. Let the wicked, meaning the Israelites, the wicked of our people, let the wicked forsake his way. and the unrighteous man his thoughts, and let him return unto the Lord. Let him repent and turn back sorrowful for the things that he have done wrong, he or she have done wrong. And he will have mercy upon them. The Lord's going to have compassion on you once you turn back. But once again, the Lord has to put his spirit on you to turn back. If the Lord don't put his spirit on you to turn back, you're going to live a careless, reckless life, and death and destruction of spirits created with vengeance are going to be waiting on you, right? And he will have mercy upon him and to our power, for he will abundantly pardon, meaning the Lord will forgive you for all your wrongful thoughts, sayings, and doings once you repent. Lord willing, we of that number. Just a quick little lesson on fearing the God of the Bible, man. Fear the Lord and live. Shalom.